Consider a regular daily example. Let us say over here, this girl is studying and she is bored and tired from doing her homework because she has been doing her homework for a very long period of time. Now, she is thinking of going out and taking a break because she has been studying, as I said, for a very long period of time. Now, what happens is, while she is thinking of going out, her mother comes in and she tells her to go out. Now, what do you think happens? This girl was already thinking of going out, and now her mother comes in and actually tells her to go out. So, what do you think happened over here? This girl who was thinking of going out will now be jumping up and down with joy, because not only has her mother told what she was thinking, but she will actually be getting a break from her studies. So let us try to analyze this situation in terms of physics. Let us say while studying, the frequency of her thoughts was X. When she wanted to go out and take a break, her frequency thoughts were Y. Now, when her mother comes in and tells her to go out, her frequency of thoughts is also Y. So what happens? Y and Y matches with one another, and there is a correlation that takes place in between mother and daughter. Or in other words, it is because the frequency of their thoughts match that the girl jumps up and down with joy, and she is overjoyed to go out. So a similar thing happens in case of vibrating or oscillating bodies. And we can use this analogy to explain the same. Now, if you recall, in our earlier discussion, we have studied about forced vibrations. What happens in forced vibrations? In forced vibrations, there is an external periodic force which is applied on the vibrating body. And after a while, the vibrating body acquires the frequency of the externally applied periodic force. So as you can see in this case, the boy is applying an external periodic force on the swing, and the swing has acquired the frequency of the periodic force. As you can see, the swing is perfectly in sync with the force that is being applied. Now, like every body in the universe, the swing will also have a natural frequency. The swing also has a natural frequency. So what do you think will happen when this oscillating swing has a frequency that matches the frequency of the external periodic force? Or in other words, to better frame the sentence, what if the external periodic force, develops a frequency that happens to match the natural frequency of the swing? Under that case also, a similar thing will happen, what happened in the case of the mother and daughter. There, because the daughter's thoughts matched with the mother's thoughts, that is, the frequency of their thoughts matched, the daughter started jumping up and down with joy. In this case, obviously the swing won't jump up and down with joy, but a particular phenomenon takes place. So in this animation, you will find what happens. The natural frequency of the swing and the frequency of the external periodic force match. As you can see, the swing starts vibrating more vigorously or oscillating more vigorously, and the amplitude of its oscillation increases gradually. That is, when the natural frequency of the swing and the frequency of the external periodic force match with one another, the swing starts vibrating with an increased amplitude and more vigorously. So this particular phenomenon that is taking place is known as resonance. Now, what is resonance? Resonance is a special case of forced vibration. That is the first and foremost condition, that it is a special case of forced vibrations. Secondly, for resonance to occur, the frequency of the externally applied periodic force has to be equal to the natural frequency of the body that is vibrating. So in the previous case when we saw, resonance occurred in the case of the swing. Why? Because the boy applied an externally periodic force on the swing, which had a frequency that matched the natural frequency of the swing. And lastly, the body readily begins to vibrate with an increased amplitude. So whenever the frequency of the externally applied periodic force matches that of the natural frequency of the body begins to vibrate with an increased amplitude, as you saw in the case of the swing. And this phenomenon is termed as resonance. Now, resonance has a certain practical application. Now, before we talk about the practical application, let us consider another phenomenon that is known as sympathetic vibrations. Now, what exactly happens in sympathetic vibrations? Notice this video carefully. Over here, you will find that when the red stick is made to vibrate, on the other end, the other red stick also begins to vibrate. And the same is true for the yellow stick. Even though only one yellow stick is made to vibrate, the other yellow stick starts vibrating along with it as soon as this one does. And the same is true for the green stick. The other green stick also vibrates when only one green stick is disturbed. So this is known as sympathetic vibrations, when a similar body placed nearby starts vibrating because the other body has been made to vibrate. Now we can apply an analogy of studying even in this case. So over here, consider the girl who was studying and was bored. She was studying along with her sibling. Now you can see both she and her sibling are studying together. Now both of them are tired and they want to go out. So let us say that their frequency while they are studying of their thoughts is X. Both of them share the same frequency because both of them are very tired and bored. Now both of them want to go out and take a break. So the frequency of their thoughts at this time is Y. Now when their mother comes in and tells them to go out, what happens? The frequency of the mother's thoughts is also Y. So this particular frequency of the mother's thoughts matches that of the girl and also that of the boy, because they were having thoughts of the same frequency. So as a result, both of them start jumping up and down with joy because the mother's frequency of thoughts has matched that of the girl as well as her sibling. So this is an analogy for sympathetic vibrations that we saw in the earlier video. Now resonance has many practical useful applications. One of its applications is in instruments, especially stringed instruments. Now as you can see, two instruments have been shown over here, a guitar and a violin, both of which are stringed instruments. Now, you must be knowing that in a guitar, there is the body of the guitar, which is a hollow part. Now, this hollow part of the body of the guitar is known as the sound box, which is also present in a violin. It contains a hollow part in the body, which is known as the sound box, and above it are the strings. Now, what do you think would have happened if this hollow part or the sound box was absent? In that case, when the guitar would have been played or the violin would have been played, the sound of the strings could not be heard by any human being. It would be impossible to hear the sound of the strings if the sound box was absent. So what is the utility of the sound box? The sound box is nothing but a hollow box in the body that contains air column. Now this air column inside it also has a natural frequency. Now the strings are made in such a way, both in case of guitar as well as violin or any stringed instrument, such that the natural frequency of the string corresponds with the natural frequency of the air column. Or in other words, they match. So the air column inside the box vibrates with the same frequency as that of the string. So what do you think happens? Resonance takes place. Now we have seen that when resonance takes place, vibrations occur with an increased amplitude, and amplitude relates to sound. That is, more the amplitude, greater will be the sound, or more loud will be the sound. So if there is resonance occurring and the vibration is taking place with a greater amplitude, a louder sound will be heard, and thus we will be able to hear the guitar being played or the violin being played. However, resonance is not always a good or a favorable factor. Let me tell you a story to that effect. It was the year 1850 in France. In the year 1850 in France, many soldiers were crossing a footbridge similar to the one that you see in the picture. Now, the footbridge, as you can see in the picture, was made of wood and strung up, as you can see. Now, this footbridge was constructed over the river Main. So, when these soldiers were crossing the footbridge over river Main, what do you think happened? They were marching in steps. Do you know how many soldiers there were? There were around 478 soldiers. So these soldiers all together were passing the footbridge at once, and all of them were marching with their steps synchronized. That is, when one soldier was placing his step, at that point of time, all the other soldiers were placing their steps. Because you must have seen during march past parades, during the Republic Day or Independence Day, how soldiers march. That is how these soldiers were marching. But do you know what happened as a result of that? As a result of their instep marching, more than 200 soldiers died. Shocking, right? Now, how do you think more than 200 soldiers died? Because when they were marching, they caused resonance in this particular bridge. Let us find out how. So we said that the soldiers are marching in steps. When the soldiers are marching in steps, it means that each soldier out of the 400 soldiers was placing his step at exactly the same point of time as the other soldiers. So as a result, their steps had a particular frequency. Now what happened is vibrations with very large energy was produced, because these steps or these vibrations had a particular frequency to them, and all the soldiers, 478 of them, were marching at the same time. So of this particular frequency, large energy vibrations were produced. Now due to this, do you know what happened? It matched the natural frequency of the suspension bridge. Or in other words, the frequency with which the soldiers were marching, that frequency somehow corresponded to the natural frequency of the suspension bridge. An unfortunate event as it was. So when this particular natural frequency and the frequency of the soldier's steps matched, what do you think happened? Resonance took place in the bridge. And due to this resonance that occurred in the bridge started shaking violently. Due to this violent shaking of the bridge, it tore from both the ends. That is, the support at both ends, which the bridge was hanging from, it broke. And due to this, the bridge crumbled because the bridge started vibrating with a large amplitude because of resonance. And this is why the bridge crumbled. So this is why more than 200 soldiers died out of so many soldiers. So it is due to this reason that while crossing such footbridges or any bridge across a point where it gets very dangerous, it is always advised to soldiers to break their steps. Now it is advisable not only for soldiers to break their steps, but also for any person. Now for example, there are many places in the world, as well as in India, especially tourist spots, where two such points are connected by a footbridge, which most probably cross a river. Now in such cases, in order to cross the river, the footbridge will have to be used. So under such circumstances, tourists are always advised to break their steps. Why? Because if they do not break their steps and march all at the same time, that is, if their steps are in sync, there is a possibility that the natural frequency of the footbridge might match the particular frequency with which the steps are being taken. And under such a circumstance, resonance will occur and the bridge could crumble. And then fatalities could occur, which would be very unfortunate. So in order to prevent such fatalities and accidents, tourists as well as soldiers or any person crossing footbridges, like the example I showed you, under such circumstances, breaking steps or taking their steps not in sync with one another is always advised in order to prevent resonance.